Hello, Gustav here. Welcome back to the 24th episode of my Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu Let's Play. In last episode, we battled Sabrina, and in this episode, we'll continue our way to the 7th gym badge. I guess we'll just switch out for another buddy. Go a little faster. There we go. Now we need to heal up real quick. Then we'll get going. Actually, today might be the episode where we finally finish out our team and get our two final members. I kind of just remembered that the one person I want on my team, I actually had to get through Pokemon Go, which means I basically could have done it a few episodes ago, to be honest. I kind of forgot. So yeah, that's a little bit bad, but that's fine. So we'll get to the Go Park right now, and yeah, we'll take it from there. Okay, then I've connected with my Pokemon Go account, and I have sent over what is going to be our newest member to the squad. So let's go find her. There she is. such a beauty. Let's catch her. Yes, it's okay. Aww. Look at her. So adorable. Cold nap. Peanut berry. There we go. There we go. Nice. Looks like snow come to life, and the breath it exhales is minus 58 degrees Fahrenheit. Another name for it is Kyokyo. Oh, that's cool. Nice. So now we got a new member to our squad. Can you return to the front desk? Yeah, you can save. That's smart. So let's check her out. She's level 20, okay. She needs some leveling up, yeah, I see. Oh, she has a mild nature. Not the best nature, but I mean, okay, I'll take what I get. We'll mist, Ice Shard, Confuse Ray, and Aurora Beam. And, yeah, IVs aren't too bad. I think she was like 84% IV in Pokemon Go, but I guess that changes a little bit when you transfer it. So that's fine. So let's take her out of the box. We can put Spark in the front. Because Vulpix obviously can't be in the front right now. He's not too strong. Oh, look how cute she is. Such an adorable little buddy. Nice, then we can continue on. I think we can just go down here to the grass, to the sea, and just go that way. I think you just get to the ice cave maybe through that. But there are a lot of trainers there that I would like to battle. We obviously need to train up a little piece. And I forgot to name her. I have thought about names, and I decided for Luna. I just think that's a really fitting name for a little. That's little ice buddy of ours. So yeah, let's get down to the sea and find all those trainers. Get that juicy experience. I guess this is also the way if you want to like have fun like Articuno. But we're not gonna go there yet. So depending on how long this takes, I might not be able to get my next buddy yet for the team, But I will get it in this episode or the next episode. That's what I'm 100% sure of. So we'll see. Ooh, a Golduck. 41. Oh, that's good levels. It's actually faster than me. Magneton is kind of slow, I have to say. We just switch out so we don't fall asleep. Cloyster, I mean, I do really want to stay in, but I don't really want to take that. Go to sleep right now. I'm tired, okay? And by the way, question of the day is, who's your favorite Alolan Pokemon? There's like, you know, Alolan Nightes, as I just got now. You have Alolan Exeggutor, Alolan Raticate, Raichu, Golem, and you name it. Yeah, who's your favorite? I think my favorite is actually, the Alolan Ninetales. I think it's such a beautiful Pokemon. And it looks so nice. I mean, I do like Ninetales as well, the regular form, but I don't know, it's just something about it, it's so nice. Ahoy! I do wonder when you're given the ability to fly around. I mean, I might have. Maybe I've just walked around those guys who can learn you that, but I really like to get the ability to fly around. It will save me a lot of time. I'm actually just gonna give a few quick candies or something to Spark so he'll. So that he can. You know, don't lose out on all the speed ties. The slowest all the time, even to all the low level Pokemon. Testing game is nice though, for Luna. Let's see if we have some quick candies we can give him. Oh, that's the Roman. The candy jar. Yeah, quick candies. Give him till it needs to. There we go, okay, maybe that's enough for him to be faster than some Pokemon. I mean, he's still gonna be slower than most, I guess, but that could make a difference in lots of battles. And having slow Pokemon is really annoying. But I mean, I'm not really choosing my team based on like the speed of the Pokemon. Then I would just have like a team of Rapidashes and Electrodes. Or something like that. Aqua Jet. Well, I guess I didn't really have to get to test out my speed. I'm pretty sure that's a fast move. Zero. Dragon Pulse, okay, so I'm still slower than a lot. Seal. Seal. I charge. And also quick moves. Hmm. Well, it doesn't do that much damage, so I'm fine. I'm fine with that. Help! The Hetman, you fine? You okay? Oh, hello. I swam here with my friends. I'm tired. Well, maybe we shouldn't have swum too far. Could be dangerous. Ooh, a Vaporeon. Ooh, we're faster. I think that's the quick handies coming in handy. So this is kind of tanky Vaporeon, so it might actually be take me out in, with this surf. Okay, that's a bit annoying, to be honest. Oh, quick attack. I was wondering if why he was faster. Nice. Oh, not to the 54. Three Pokeballs. I don't really need all your Pokeballs. They're not really what I want to get. They're so useless at this point of the game. So weak. I don't want to complain and be like... I do appreciate getting things, you know, but... The Pokeballs aren't really doing much for me. Every Pokemon meat is too strong for them. It's like red circles all around. We almost have to use Ultra Balls anyway, so... And, I mean, if I'm ever gonna go shiny anything back in a lower grass area, it's not too bad to have, but, you know, really not that useful right now. This should just take him out. It's 4x effective. Yep. Gyarados really don't want to deal with electric type Pokemon. Oh, Kasper up to 52, Luna to 22. Good job, Gyar. Oh, I just love that what you're riding. You'll give it to me if I win, right? What I'm riding? You mean my board or my Pikachu? But the answer is no to both. I mean, not like you're gonna beat me anyway, but. Oh no, Seal isn't a ice type Pokemon. So this won't have super effective. It's only when it evolves you get the ice type. So now it's just really bad. Wow. I always forget, like with Seal and Shellder, that they're actually not ice type Pokemon. They only get ice type when they evolve. Which I think is kind of stupid. I think they should have been able to be ice type Pokemon as well. It would be much better for them, I think. But hey, at least they get ice when I evolved. I mean, that's the most important thing, right? But hey, I guess that was the challenge, like in Pokemon Go, when you were trying to get like the ice medal, where you had to catch so and so many ice type Pokemon to get the medal, the gold medal, and. It took quite some time in Generation 1 since, like, you had to basically catch the evolved type to get them. It became easier, of course, when the newer generation came out and there were more ice type Pokemon to catch, but in the beginning, that the thing goes fast. You don't think I can swim? I mean, I'm not a great swimmer, but I can swim. I'm not really the biggest fan of swimming though, so I kind of prefer staying above the water, to be perfectly honest. Oh nice, it actually took me one hit. I didn't think it would. Discolog doesn't have that good a defense. And Gyarados. Well, we know what happens with Gyaroses. We grill those. Grill champ. Oh yeah. And spark up to 47. Nice. Luna to 23. She's catching up. That's good. I am probably have to going to have to do some off-screen training with her at some point, because I think it's going to take a little bit long to get her up to speed with the rest of the team in this way. So I might have to do some training. The Seafarm Islands are a quiet getaway. I'm vaccinating here. Yeah, okay, cool. Yeah, so I think I'm going to wait until I get like my final part of the team, so I can, like, you know, train them both at once. If the other one is also a low level, which I suspect it might be. Spark is really reliable here out in the water. Guess you can switch out for that one. Just to like save some Thunderbolts. It's like I think a Shadow Ball is gonna take him out. Take it out quite easily. Yep. Starm is definitely a Pokemon I consider having on the team. I don't think I've used it so many times before, and I think it's a cool Pokemon. But I did decide on another water type Pokemon, as I now, you know, revealed it is a water type Pokemon, who's gonna be the last addition to my team, which is gonna be helpful at the next gym, of course. Since that's a fire type gym, I'm just of course gonna have to train it up first. So yeah, oh, who are you? Potion delivery system. No need to pay, we hope to continue to support your neighborhood Pokemon. Wait, what? Did she heal them up, or did she heal them up actually? That's so cool. So here's the Seafarm Island. I guess we can go check out the entrance. I mean, this is probably just where you catch Articuno, so I'm not really gonna bother going through the whole cave, because basically it's gonna be a waste of time. But I can take his trainers who's here in the front, and we can get a new Pokemon to the Dex, Jinx. Oh, it was the sideways throws. There you go. I got to get better at this. I mean, yeah, I've complained before that they're hard to do, but maybe I'm just bad, I don't know. See, this one I'm really struggling with. I don't understand. How do you get it to the side? I can't. I have to wait for it to jump to the other side. If it doesn't do that, you're just gonna have to run. It's actually impossible for me to throw it to the right. It goes to the left. I really don't understand this. Now it goes to the front. Yeah, okay. I didn't want to jinx it in a way. Can I just battle the trainers over here? Even when pushing blocks with strong push, Pokemon can get in the way. When that happens, I use a repel so I can get back to pushing with no problems. Oh, so that could be like the perks of having repels and such. I see. Oh, that's a Dewgong. Dewgong! Nice. You didn't up level? Nice. Ice Beam. Wow. Didn't expect her to learn that early. You can get rid of Aurora Beam. It's like basically just a worsen. You know, it's not too bad. You can lower the attack and such, but Ice Beam just so much better. Nice. His entire body is a snowy white. Unharmed by even intense cold, it swims powerfully in icy waters. Add it to the party. Yeah. I'll give this trick another go. Maybe it doesn't go. It won't go to the right. It goes to the left. I have been able to throw it to the left a little bit more. Like, now it goes to the... Actually, it's just the opposite. I think there's something wrong with what I'm doing. I don't know what it is, but I'm doing something wrong. And I need to find out about it really soon, because I'm wasting so many Pokeballs by throwing, yeah, those throws. Okay, stay in the middle. I might have a chance. Actually running out of Ultra Balls. Guess I have to buy some more. It's a good thing to have them laying around. And we managed to get it. Actually. Appears to move to a rhythm of its own, as if it were dancing. It wiggles its hips as it walks. Jinx is really just a... Design-wise, I really don't like Jinx. I think it looks bad. I don't know. It's just a really weird Pokemon. And I'm not really a big fan of it. So, yeah. Oh, wow. Slowbro. Yo, bro! I have two more Ultra Balls. See if that's enough. 1, 2, 3. Strike! We are out! Nice! Got him. Oh, Luna grew up level. This is some good training. Okay, getting the new Pokemon to the decks. As well. Two flies in one bag. Lives lazily by the sea. If the shoulder of an cell comes off, it becomes a slowpoke again. What? It can actually de-evolve? I didn't think that was a possibility. I mean, I do have I actually a slowpoke? I don't remember if I have a quantum of this. Oh my god, what am I doing? Whoa, why did that go that way? It's just the same thing there. Am I like the only one who's struggling with this, or are any of you guys like struggling with the throwing technique? I mean, I don't know if I'm doing anything wrong, or if I'm holding it wrongly, or I don't know, something like that. But let me know down in the comments if you are struggling with this, or if it's just me. I would like to know that. Are you surprised to find a coach trainer at a place like this? But what is more surprising is that I come here every single day. There is nothing else to do but battle here. Do you want to battle? Yep. I want to battle. Yes. Ooh, a Jolteon. I mean, it doesn't have the best defense stats, so a Tri-Attack should do a good amount. Didn't do too much, to be honest. I think I'm just gonna have to switch out. No one really wants to take that Thunder, though. So I guess Cuckoo is the best bet. Oh, and he missed. Wow. Two misses. You're one lucky, unlucky guy. I mean, he's probably faster than me, so it's her time to charm. But he don't want to too much. And Riren, I think he should just knock it out. Knock her out. Nice. And a Flareon. So you're just one of these guys. Let's just switch into Natsu. And dig him. Let's dig a diggy hole. That should do a good amount. Flare Blitz, actually. Are you like some kind of suicide bomber? If you do that again, you might just knock yourself out now. Let's see. Oh, that does a lot. It's a powerful move, though. But goodbye. Not sure if that's what I would call worth it, but who am I to judge? Natsu up to level 55. Nice. Luna 26. And finally one of Vaporeon. As expected, then we can go back to Spark. Let's see. No. I'm faster again, of course. And it does half, so we're fine. And he even misses the cyber pump. So we Gucci. Well, you came all the way out, way here. Let me give you something really special. Hi, rare candies. Thank you, man. That's really appreciated. Don't you feel happy when you have a whole bunch of different candies in your candy jar? Yeah, it's good to have. I mean, it's nice. I mean, when I'm here, I should have been seeing some seals, maybe, or actually getting a slowpoke. There's a seal. And that's a slowpoke. Just as we're talking about them. Seal might run away in this meantime, but I'm just gonna use the Great Balls then. Should be good enough at this. God, I'm so bad. Don't judge me, please. Or just, I mean, do it. I mean, I don't care. Judge me if you want. I mean, I should take Dewgong out of the team, but if I do, when I get a new one, right, if you right away, I fill in the space, so I mean. Incredibly slow and sluggish. It is quite content to lull about without worrying about the time. Okay, now let's see if that seal is still there, and if we get the seal. I think we have gotten everything we want to get here. Is there something we could be potentially missing? No, I think this is the last one. Can't think of anything else we have to get in this cave. Except Articuno. I don't really remember though if it's on this side or the other side, but I think it's on this side. I don't really see any reason for me to catch it right now, so I'm not going to be using it anyway. I think I would just struggle to actually beat it in time. I mean, maybe not. I don't really know how strong it is, so I'm not really sure, but arigato. So yeah, I'm just gonna run off to Peloton actually, and we'll take it from there. Okay, so then we're back here in Peloton, and we can start on a journey down towards the next gym. But I think we're gonna leave that for the next episode. Yeah, we'll do that. So yeah, if you like the video, press the like button, and remember to answer your answer to the question of the day: who's your favorite Alolan Pokemon? Said mine is the Alolan Ninetales, which we're going to get evolve pretty soon, I promise. And yeah, subscribe if you're new. So until next time, bye.